Hello friends, I'm Chia. There's no doubt that one day you'll be bringing your husband or wife to Europe, anyway, abroad, to come and join you. But what happens after then? Will he or she run away? Yeah, that's what you will know now. In case you're here for the first time, why don't you subscribe? Please press that bell, because without a bell, nothing like notification, okay? Now please press it, okay? Thank you all to my greatest subscribers. You guys are great. But remember to share as usual to friends on WhatsApp, Facebook, so that they will learn, so that when they be bringing their wife or husband, so that they will not do the same mistakes that they are still doing till now. Okay. Now a lot of people say, bring your wife, husband to Europe and they will just leave you and run away. How true is that? Tell me what you think in the comment section also. I would love to know. Let's share ideas, okay? So now listen, what really happens? Now, let's say some of you have been dating some girls you find online or you knew them before coming here. But what matters most in life is to marry your soulmate, your best friend, you know? Meaning that you have already understood this person in and out. Character-wise, everything, behavior, what she likes, do's and don'ts. And if you're okay with it, then you move on. Now, you can bring such person, that partner of yours abroad. Meaning that there's clear understanding. Someone who shares your dream. Like some men don't like women who they'll marry and let's say the lady is a career lady and this lady comes abroad and she's working and you know, the man starts feeling inferior, insecure, like she's making money more than me now. Oh, very soon she'll start commanding me, she'll not be respecting me anymore. You know? So before you know it, the pride issue comes in. And he's, before you know, there's quarrel in the home, you know, because he's trying to be superior now. Before you know it, there's quarrel, fighting, beating comes in. And let me tell you, any girl you are beating, the love she has for you will start going down. The love keeps going down day by day. And let me tell you, the next guy out the door there shows her love. Before you know it, she's having feelings for another guy. Nothing for you anymore. So beating a girl, your wife, doesn't solve anything. All you need to do is to sit down and talk, you know, talk it out. And let me tell you, before you as a girl decide to marry a man, you know, ask yourself, why are you getting married to this person? Are you doing it for the right reason or just because the person is abroad, because of the money? Is that why you are doing it? You know, now let me tell you, because a character you cannot change in a man in a relationship will continue in that same marriage. So if the man is abusive, even in relationship, the abusiveness will continue in the marriage. If he's smoking or drinking, you cannot stop it in the relationship. You say, don't worry, when we get married, I will change him. No, it will continue in that same marriage. So be careful when you take these decisions to go into marriage. And let me tell you, you men, where you find your partner matters a lot. If you find a girl in the club, be careful, you know? So the situation you find her tells more what will play out in that marriage. You know, some characters you neglect, you feel the way she's shouting at you in relationship, she doesn't respect you in relationship, you feel that in the marriage she's going to respect you. No, the same thing happens. Now let's move on. Will she run away? Will he run away? It depends on you. How is your behavior to her when she came? You know, because some of you prefers that she will turn to a total house girl, doing all the house chores, forgetting that in Europe abroad here, we don't have house girls here. She's a human being, of course. She's a human being. She could be tired sometimes too, you know? So you still come back, expect her to prepare food for you, everything, and you still give her the normal pounding at night, you know, making love to her. Sometimes she's not even in the mood anymore because she's already tired, walking, cleaning there, going to the market, washing your clothes, ironing it. And you still come back and complain. You did not cook well. You did not do this. You did not do that. You did not dress well. Where will she find the time? She goes out there to find a job. You are equally insecure. You know? Before you know it, you are beating her up. Beating her up daily. She's losing the love. Family influence comes in now. Friends keep telling her. We now start telling her, hey, what are you doing with this man? Why don't you run away? Look at the way he's beating you all the time. He comes back. Family is telling her, leave that marriage. This man is abusive on you. Look, if you marry a girl and you bring her here in Europe, you have to learn to also help her doing some house chores. Even the white men, they do it. They help their wives sometimes. They go to the kitchen and cook. There's no big deal. Sometimes they themselves go for the shopping for their wives. You know, even clean houses, cut grass is outside. You guys see these things. So don't bring the African lifestyle here or the Asian lifestyle here in Europe or America. Anyway, it doesn't work. So you have to help your wife. Okay, come to think of it. You say, oh, but I'm working, bringing the money home, paying the bills, this and that. At the same time, you are scared of allowing her to go and work. You know? So now, you say you are working, you pay bills, fine. Okay, think of what she's doing. Do you know if as a cleaner, let's say she's cleaning the house, arranging the home, go and ask how much they pay domestic workers, people who work in the house of people, the white men. They pay them big. Now, she works every day cleaning house. Can you pay her for that? She works every day cleaning house. Okay, go and ask how much they pay people who are working in the restaurant, washing plates, cleaning the kitchen. Big money too. Big money, but this is what she does. You don't pay her for these things. You don't see these ones. You know, she washes your clothes, iron it. Go and ask how much they pay people who iron clothes. Big money. This thing she does, you don't see these things. Go and ask how much, you know, for you know, buying babies. People who go to buy babies, adopt them. But she will get pregnant. In the pregnancy, she's still doing all these things. You don't pay her for these things. But you will say, I've already bought her. She's my property. I paid her bride price. Don't look at your wife as your property. Your wife is your best friend, your soulmate, your everything. You have to treat her with love and respect. Okay? So now, you cannot pay her for all these things that she's doing at home. Yet you're equally complaining. She's lazy. She's that. She didn't do this. She didn't do that. You yourself, you only went to work, came back and relaxed. What about her? Doesn't she need that relaxing too? You know, you need to even pet her more. Okay, since, you know, most of you bring this to your wife, you want them to just stay at home, making babies and cleaning house for you. But you know, how much do you pay them? Nothing. So by the time you start beating them up, shouting at them, insulting them, then they look for someone else out there who is going to give them more comfort and love, which is another random guy out there, another hunter who is waiting for your mistake. Because when you make mistakes in marriage, there's another guy out there who is willing and ready to take her in and give her that love that you can't give to her. So before you know it, you say, oh, girls, when you bring them here, they run away. Even girls too who invite guys, their husbands, to come and join them. The same thing. When you bring them, you start wanting to show them that you are the boss in the house. You talk down on them. Before you know it, they are like, okay, because you brought me, right? Once I get this document, I'll just leave you and run away. Because now there's another girl he's talking with. This girl is giving her the love, attention, everything, the respect. But you don't do it. Before you know it, he's thinking of running away. And another thing, what is intention? Because when you just go back home and marry any random person you just met for 1 month, 2 months, you don't really know this person that much. This person may say, well, what's my business? I'll just get married. What I know is that when I come there, as soon as I get document, I just run away. So these are the problems, you know. Some people will say, that's why you need to date a girl for 1 year, for 2 years, you know. But come to think of it, even the whites, I don't think dating for long matters here, you know. You can't know the character of everybody that much. There are people still who brought their partners and still they are till now, they are still intact. Because why? They have understanding. When you have understanding, you know, you want to make your wife grow. Both of you want to grow together, plant things together. That is the motive of being a family. Plant things together and make a better future. Not like wanting to suppress her, to talk her down, you know. And some of you girls who are depending on guys for everything, look, let me tell you, you are also a human being. Why don't you equally try to hustle things for yourself even before getting married? Let me tell you, if you have your own money, that guy will give you respect. But when guys look down on girls, it's because they feel girls depend 100% on them for almost everything, for clothes, shoes, bags, makeup, perfume, money, pocket money, all the rest, making hair. But when you show these guys that you're independent, even before they marry, they'll be scared. They will now start minding the way they talk to you, because now they know that when they met you as a independent lady. So there will be respect. And both of you must share dreams together too. So what am I talking about here? That it happens when the abuse comes in the marriage. No respect anymore. The love goes down. Another person takes over. Okay, let me just tell you like this story. Where this guy brought this girl. He just brought her from back home. You know, they didn't date for long. and he brought her because he was so abusive on her. Every day comes back home, insults her, demand for food and the rest. You know, fighting, insults. Before he knows it, the girl was like, okay, I want to go for holiday in UK. That's the end. She's gone. He went into depression, stress and the rest. Another time he was like, okay, people, friends talked him into getting married to another person, which he did after 3 years of the first one leaving. Okay, he went for a younger girl of about 20 years old. What happened? The same thing. He never changed his character. He wanted to suppress this one too. Abusing, insulting, beating and the rest. Not appreciating her efforts until this random white guy who is living opposite their house in the street there, the same street. This girl started going to him. This white guy started showing her more comfort, much love that this guy couldn't give. Before he knows it, friends told him, but he never believed. But one day he came back home. The second girl left. Took her things and packed into the white guy's house. You know, you can't take her back anymore. So the white guy got married to her. You know, planned more better life, gave her much love. So when you don't do these things, it happens. You know? So don't say it's all about dating for long. Even the whites, they date for long, 5 years, 10 years. But what happened? After 3 years of their marriage, 4 years, they break up. There is much breakup even in their own marriages. So it's not all about how long did you date. It's how much do you know the person? How much do you understand each other? The love, the everything. How much is it? Don't marry for the wrong reasons. Only because she's beautiful. Only because her backside is big. Or girls, all because he's rich, he's handsome, you know, he got the muscles, six packs. Is that why you're getting married? Marry because he got the brain, the respect, the love. These are the things you should check out for. He has plans for the future, you know, intelligence. Not marrying for those kind of crazy wrong reasons, because when the backside is gone, it's over. When the handsomeness, the beauty is out, it's over. When the flat tummy turns big, it's over. So marry for the right reasons, okay? So if you get things right, your partner will not leave you when you bring them abroad. They will respect you much. Check around. Those who got it right are still living together with their partner, making plans, investing back home, you know, big dreams till this day, with their children, still planning, you know, because understanding is there. All right, I'll be stopping here. Just show me love, okay? Show me that love by pressing the like button. That's the best you can do for me. Remember to share to friends on WhatsApp, Facebook. Tell me what you think in the comment section. Your opinion. What do you think? Okay? Subscribe, please, and press that bell beside it. That bell. With that bell, you get notification. And if you're not getting notification till now, please press that bell. Okay? Ciao, ciao. I'm Chi.